George, tell us about the virus for this building, your Houston portfolio, other things. How has the virus impacted your ability to do CapEx or do unit turns and leasing? You tell us about what's going on kind of in real time with the virus impact.
Yeah, as far as the CapEx items, we really haven't had any major hiccups. You know, here in Texas, construction was deemed essential. For the most part, I mean, the only thing we've had issues with is maybe some, and that's not even with our multifamily renovations, that's with a new development ground up. Some specialty items have been hard to get. So that part's gone pretty smooth. We've actually gotten a ton done in the past 6-7 weeks. Then with the leasing, you know, that's become a little more difficult. And I don't want to say difficult, because I mean, we are leasing units. We've just had to adapt. You know, the leasing offices are open, but they're appointment only, trying to push everything to be, or as much as we can, as far as online, doing virtual tours. And if as far as work orders on the properties, you know, just sticking to the emergency work orders, and then making sure to keep our staff safe. You know, there's guidelines that we put out there as far as masks and gloves. I know in Houston, no one's able to enter the office without having a mask or a glove. And same thing with maintenance. If they come in, they need to have their masks and gloves.
What are your thoughts on where we're at today? Like, just, do you feel like things are unthawing? Do you think they're getting a little easier? Do you think some of the fear is gone? Or where do you think we're at in kind of the cycle? I know everybody's kind of experience with this is very personal and regional, right? So just kind of what are your thoughts on where you guys are at?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's going to be very area specific, but as far as the areas we're in, I'm feeling pretty good about it. Both Texas and Oklahoma have opened back up. Texas is opening salons and other things. I think we're doing good on that end. I'm curious to see what happens with, you know, hopefully we don't have another peak or a second wave, like they're saying. Everybody continues to be smart about this. That's really my only fear. And then it's, how long does the economy take to get back? You know, there's going to be some businesses that are not going to survive, you know, and how's that going to affect everything? As far as collections today, we did pretty well in April, better than we thought, honestly. We did jump ahead of it and get in front of it, but May's starting to come in. It's been a little bit less than April. I'm really curious to see how we do in May and then come June as well.
Yeah, again, referencing back to Crosby Park, for our audience to understand what the goal is, you know, we are all into that building. $6.1 million purchase, $1.2 million of renovation, all in for basically $7.7 million. Got a bridge loan for $5.9 million, and then private investors for $1.8 million. And the goal was, again, through those. The reason why I'm asking, the reason why this is important, is because what George and I and Tim and all of our apartments, what we're looking at is stabilization. And a bank is going to look at the numbers to see, well, how many units did you have? How many units were occupied? And then how many units were actually collected, right? How many people actually paid? Not just occupied, but paid. And you really got to be at that 90% occupancy or better to turn around and qualify for an agency loan with Fannie and Freddie. So that's always been our goal. And we anticipate, based on these increased rents with this particular project, to be at a value of about $10.5 to $11 million in order to refinance. So it's important for us now is to kind of manage what's going on with May, what's going on with June, what's going on with July. And that's going to be important, but that might be a short-term hiccup, right, George? Says at the end of the year, what we really need to see is, like, in Q4 or Q1 of 2021, we need to see 3 months of 90% occupancy or better to qualify for a new agency loan. And at that time, we got to be, you know, increased rent, 90% occupancy for 90 days. And then you kind of qualify for that. And the good news there is Fannie Freddie money is so cheap right now. It's ridiculous. So even if we have a short-term hiccup or some short-term challenges, that's why I really look more at the long term, right? What's going to happen really by the end of Q3, beginning of Q4, because we've got to position that building and your other buildings for these refinances that are going to take place around the end of the year. And really, George, nobody has a crystal ball, right? Like, nobody knows. We can all say we think, But really, what's going to happen with May and then what's going to happen with June and July is going to be very, very important. April was very strong.